So, this yogi, yes. So sitting meditation, aware of the pen, and then she can know the knowing mind and the pen is separate. And then that moment there was no self.
Mm-hmm.
And then again when she know the feeling and thinking, and then she can know the mind just aware.
Mm-hmm.
And then the object and knowing mind is different. It's independent.
Mm-hmm.
Just in the present moment, just knowing mind and knowing object.
Yes. Mm. Yes.
So she feel very happy.
Mm.
She can know the mind.
Okay. Mm. Keep going.
Mm.
We need to know many mind. Still need to know many mind.
Yeah.
Now you start to notice about the mind activity, right?
Mm.
And later you can see more things and more interest.
Mm. 但是说你现在能够观察到很多新的这个活动嘛，那下来慢慢你就会觉得越来越有兴趣啊，这个修行。Mind
is so fast, so quick, and a lot of activity. You move, but so fast you know the gross level, and slowly you can see the more subtle level, more we said unconscious level.
Yes.
Mean is that you cannot know. If you can know, this is not unconscious. Because unconscious, we don't know, that's why we set unconscious level. But if you're aware, we can separate yourself, but this level also you can know.
And
Yomi said, she said she noticed, he noticed about his mental state. The consciousness and consciousness, they flow their way. When he is mindful, and he mindful, and he doing, he consciously, he don't know, but he doing there many things, but awareness present. When he suddenly, his slipper, he get take off the slipper. When the consciousness don't understand why he take off the slip, because you need to wear the without slipper you cannot with the slipper you cannot wear the pen, right?
But did not see the intention and then
not yet. No see, but consciously the mind not understanding
why
this but through unconscious level is that he do his job already. So there's a flow, many flow is
happening.
Very interesting.
反正说有一个禅修者报告的主题就是他能够看到这个，就是关心的时候，同时意识跟潜意识同时在流动。他说什么意思？就是他穿裤子嘛，他穿裤子的时候，突然发现他的脚把鞋给脱了。 然后但是他很深心很深疑问说，我穿裤子我脱鞋干嘛？然后后来他其实，然后他这个疑问以后，他发现其实是什么？是因为你穿裤子的话不脱鞋怎么样？很难穿。
He planning already.
嗯，she's saying the mindfulness not cannot catch this subtle process.
Yes, subtle level, but the mind notice this is some process is already flowing.
Yes.
But we only know the mind, we think the mind is the one. But a lot of mind activity, the mind is so fast, so quick and happening. If your awareness become more sharper and sharper, you can see the more this mental process. If you more aware, recognize this mental process, then you can more understanding, there's really, there's no body there. They have their own cause and their own effect process. Very strongly, you can understand later and later.
然后它一直在流动，很多很多很多的心。然后呢，但是我们呢，只看到很表面的，我们觉得只有一个心，啊，但是其实呢，它是很多，然后都是因缘的发生的过程。然后你 看得越来越清楚，就是理解越来越深了以后，你可以看到它真的就是因果的因缘发生的这样因果的一个过程，然后慢慢你就会真的理解什么是无我。
She said when she's dreaming in the night, and in the dream also is aware the thinking and practicing mindfulness, and at the same time the mind knows she's asleep, and also the mind can know sleep and then practicing mindfulness in the dream.
Yeah, because the mind thinking about the practice all the time. That's why the in the dream also the mind thinking about the practice.
他说因为心一直在想的时候，所以梦里面就这么想，很正常。
That's why some meditation teacher they ask me one question: Are you practicing in the dream? That means how much you practice, you thinking about practicing, how much intention you interest about practicing.
他说有一些中心，有一些禅修老师会问大家一个问题：你梦有梦到禅修吗？梦里梦到在练习吗？ 这个问题其实就是为了检验大家自己有多上心。